As your mobile device is busy executing tasks, calculating how to split a bar tab, and uploading photos of your cat, the underlying hardware is effectively pulling energy from your battery to accomplish this work. And as we've all seen, the more work your device does, the more battery it pulls, and the sooner your users are left holding onto an uncharged phone that doubles as a really expensive doorstop. My name is Colt McAnlis, and the key to writing applications that are light on battery drain has everything to do with understanding how the process works under the hood. See, in the electrical engineering world, this action of hardware pulling energy from the battery to execute a task is called current draw over time. And anyone who has an undergraduate in electrical engineering will tell you, not every action on your device draws the same amount of battery in the same way over the same period of time. To prove this, let's take a handy Nexus 5 device, turn it in airplane mode, and then let it sit on our desk. Now, if we leave the phone like this doing nothing, we'll roughly get a month of life before the battery is completely exhausted. We can consider this baseline. But that's typically not how these devices are actually used. As soon as you're active with your device, you're going to be eating up more battery. Now, active in this context includes anything like CPU doing work, booting up the cellular radio to transmit data, or the screen itself being awake. So the question is, what tasks are my application doing that are eating up the most battery? And sadly, this really isn't an easy answer. See, monitoring battery drain at a hardware level is a catch-22, because of course the monitoring hardware itself then needs to eat up the phone's battery in order to execute the actions to record how much battery is actually being drained. As such, most devices that aren't specialty don't do this. The only real way to gather these types of statistics on battery draw is to attach a third-party piece of hardware to your Android device, which can record these operations without using up the phone's power to do so. Now, when we do this, we get some really, really interesting information. For example, we can see that when the Nexus 5 is in standby mode, there's actually not much power drain going on. But when we wake up our device and turn on the screen, we can see there's a huge spike in the battery monitor. I mean, which you'd kind of expect, right? Turning on the LEDs, painting the screen, and then all the CPU, GPU work required to draw on the screen isn't free from a battery perspective. Which, by the way, is completely different than when an application wakes up the device. Say, if it's using a wake lock or an alarm manager or a job scheduler API. When a device is asleep and is woken up through one of these APIs, you'll see an initial battery spike as the processor first boots up, followed by a bit of battery draw as some work is executed. Now, it's worth pointing out that once the work is over, the device will go back to sleep. And this is really important. Sleep saves battery life. If you forget to let the device sleep or keeping the device awake for long periods of time, the battery is going to become drained in no time. Now, your mobile cellular radio is a completely different story. That is, anytime your device tries to send data over the mobile network. You can see that there's a quick wake-up cost associated with getting your mobile hardware ready, followed by a large spike for sending out a packet and receiving one back. Now, because the radio getting started process is so expensive, the hardware itself will actually stay awake for a short period of time after it's done executing work in case there are more packets coming its way from the network. This is great data, right? I mean, this is cool stuff, but sadly most developers don't have access to this kind of equipment. Thankfully, with the L release of Android, we've got a whole new set of tools to help you optimize battery draw for your application. Firstly, users can see how much battery your application is drawing with our new on-device battery details data. You can access this by opening Settings, clicking on Battery, and then choosing your application, at which point you'll be provided with key details about how much time your application is spending keeping the phone awake or doing networking tasks. And trust me, if your app's battery profile looks like this, you might be in trouble. Secondly, there's a brand new tool that lets you visualize these same battery eating actions over the usage cycle of your application. The Battery Historian tool allows you to create a timeline for each task that you can easily see how often, for example, your app starts up the radio. This information gives you a clear target for your battery optimization efforts. But honestly, fixing these issues is a whole separate topic entirely, which is why you need to check out the rest of the Android Performance Patterns content, which will teach you the beautiful zen of battery management. So keep calm, profile your code, and always remember, perf matters.